Welcome back to Albany County Fasteners, Fasteners 101. I'm Bob, and today I'm going to show you how to mix some concrete. But before we do that, please subscribe, like, and share my videos, and hit the bell so you get new content warnings. Let's get started. This is a bag of concrete, 50 pounds. It's quick setting concrete. This is what I selected. They have quick setting, they have slow setting, you know, many different mixtures you can find at your home improvement store. This is by Quickcrete. I did many years of concrete work. And many would think that, you know, it's a bag of concrete, it's pre-mixed. Well, there are some important things that you need to know, especially with fast setting concrete. Fast setting concrete sets very quickly, so you have to have your materials ready before you mix the concrete. And I'm going to show you how to properly mix the concrete. So I poured some of this fast-setting concrete into this bucket. It's a 5-gallon bucket, I guess. You get these at Lowe's or Home Depot, any of those. One good thing to do before you're going to put any water in is make sure you mix the materials around after you pour it out of the bag. And that makes sure that all the materials are nice and loose. Now, a couple of tips. If you go to your box store and you buy a bag of this product, and you come back and you have chunks or it's not fine, bring it back, get a new bag. But sometimes when they ship these products, they're out exposed to the elements. They could get hit with water. And then the product, if it starts to set up, it's no good. So I would highly recommend that you make sure that you have fine product. Now I'm going to go get some water, and we're going to start to mix the product. So I got my water. This is cold, clean tap water. Do not use hot water. Hot water will set the concrete faster. So you want to avoid doing that. It's a good thing to just pull out of the center here, pull to the side some of the concrete, and just basically dig a little hole there to pour the water in. And I'm going to start to pour this in, then I'm going to mix it. And you want to go a little bit at a time, not too much, because then it'll become too soupy, and then you'll have to put some more concrete in, which I might have to do here, but I'm just gonna keep mixing it. And I'll probably need more than what I have here anyway to do this little project I'm doing. And you just keep mixing it. And again, make sure you get the bottoms and the sides, because otherwise you're gonna have dry pockets with dry concrete, and you gotta make sure you mix it well. Now I'm using this ladle. You can also get a battery drill and put a concrete auger on it and mix it that way. But for this, I'm just doing it by hand. Make sure you get down to the bottom. You get everything mixed well. I'm almost down there now. Now you don't want it soupy like it is here, so I'm going to add some more concrete to this. But you want to make sure that it's well mixed. And you're better off when you have fast setting concrete that it's a little more wet, because the drier, the faster it's going to set up on you. Okay, come all the way down to the bottom now. And now it's coming together well. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna add some more concrete. I like to start off more soupy than dry, because it makes it easier to get everything that's on the bottom. If you're working on your project, and as you get to the bottom and you find the concrete is setting up because this is fast set, do not add water to loosen up the product. Throw it out, start off with a new batch. Even if it's a little bit, just make sure you put a little bit in there and very little water. Sometimes with the cups of your hand or a little cup, pour the water in as you mix it so you can finish your project off. It's a little tip. And always a little bit at a time. Don't go too fast, because if you put too much in, then it's gonna get very dry very quickly. And then you're gonna be putting more water in. This is getting perfect now. Now this is a small batch. You can get a big tub with a hoe and you can mix it and just keep feeding. Break your bags open, put it into a big bin. We're almost there. This is getting to the perfect consistency that I want. And also, this is fast setting. So fast setting, once it starts to get to that consistency, we'll start to set up pretty quickly. Just need a little bit more. Not much. I think this is gonna do it. Yep. Now you can see it. That's what I'm looking for. Okay. I don't see any dry material. You want to make sure you have nothing dry. You want to make sure it's thoroughly mixed. And always wear protection. You need gloves. Should have a mask on so you don't inhale this stuff. It's not the greatest stuff for you. Concrete has lime in it. You need to protect your skin from it, because if you use it many, many times, it also can do some damage to your skin. They don't tell you that typically, but that's, you learn that over the years. So here we are. Looks good. Just found a little dry spot there. But I think I'm good for my little project. That's the perfect consistency that I want. It's not too watery, but it is nice and chunky and thick. And this will set up pretty quickly once I put it into the product that I'm trying to develop here for my next video. A piece of concrete that is already setting up, and then you pour a fresh batch on top of that, they call that a cold joint. That's where you're going to have a possible break, and you'll see a joint in the concrete. So you kind of want to, when you're working with concrete, you want to move fairly quickly, especially fast setting. Slow setting, normal setting, you know, it's much more easier to work with. I would highly recommend that if you haven't worked with concrete before. If you have a bag and you have extra material, it's good to roll this up, take it, put it in a plastic bag, like so. Seal it up tight. Make sure you don't have any holes in the bag, because once you break that paper bag open, moisture in your garage or your basement will start to penetrate the concrete. And then when you go to use it, let's just say 2 months, 3 months, this will prolong the life. If it's over a year old, chances are that you'll come back to this and it will be chunky. You just need to throw it out at that point. A final tip. Cleaning. Do not clean concrete buckets out in your slop sink, your toilet, your regular sink in your house, your bathtub. Don't do it. Clean it outside, get a hose, clean the concrete out in your grass somewhere that you just don't want to see it. It will leave a residue around. If you clean it out in your sink, slop sink, toilet, or your bathtub, the trap in the plumbing will collect the concrete, sand, and it will set up in there. And the end result is it will reduce the amount of flow of water and whatever else is in there by a substantial amount, thus clogging your sink eventually. Hair will cling to it. A lot of people do this. It's a big mistake. Don't do it. That's how you mix a bag of concrete. I probably used about 75% of this bag. Thanks for watching. Leave me some comments. Give me your thoughts. I can pour it if I want to, but it's just easy for me. It's on here. It's not going to come out. Right?